Welcome to the CycloneDX Learning Series. In the next few minutes, we'll explore the different types of data that go into CycloneDX SBOMs. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll get notified of new episodes that can help you and your organization get the most from CycloneDX. Ready? Let's dive in. CycloneDX is a flagship OWASP standard that's designed by security professionals for cybersecurity use cases. So what's the anatomy of a CycloneDX SBOM? Let's find out. CycloneDX is designed first and foremost as a bill of material format. Every SBOM has a version number and ideally will include a unique serial number. The first section of the SBOM is metadata, which includes the supplier, manufacturer, and the target component for which the SBOM describes. It also includes the tools used to create the SBOM along with licensing information for the SBOM document itself. CycloneDX does not have a default license for the SBOM. Rather, organizations are free to choose any open source license, any commercial license, or any other type of license for their SBOM. Terms of use and non-disclosure language can also be included. Components are the next section of the SBOM and describe the complete inventory of first-party and third-party software. The identity of components can be represented as coordinates, including the component's group, name, and version, and may also include the package URL, CPE, or SWID tag ID. Cryptographic hash functions such as SHA-1, SHA-2, and SHA-3, along with Blake-2B and Blake-3, can also be specified. CycloneDX can represent any type of software component, including applications, frameworks, libraries, containers, operating systems, devices, firmware, and even files. Components may also include the supplier and manufacturer information, license and copyright details, and every component can optionally include the complete pedigree and provenance for that component. And this is especially important for components that are modified or derivatives of other components. Components may also include external references, which can describe a component's website, links to documentation, support, and distribution sites, version control, issue trackers, even external SBOMs, and feeds for security advisories. There are many different types of external references that can be communicated in the SBOM. Components may include other components to form a component assembly. This nested relationship is ideal for software that is statically linked or for large modular applications. Every component or component assembly can also be digitally signed. CycloneDX supports XML signature and JSON signature format for enveloped signing cases. The combination of component assemblies and digital signatures makes advanced multi-supplier use cases really simple to achieve. We'll discuss this in more detail in a future episode. The next section of the SBOM are services, which can describe remote functions, REST or GraphQL APIs, or any other URI, including those accessible over HTTP, MQTT, or inter-process or network-accessible sockets. Services are an important part of the SBOM's inventory and may include endpoint URIs, data flow classifications, and the directional flow of data between component and services, trust boundary traversals, even authentication requirements. There's enough information about services to automatically generate a data flow diagram useful for threat modeling. Providing a comprehensive view of inventory, including components and services, gives you a much more holistic view of the software stack in your supply chain. The next section of the SBOM describes dependency relationships. CycloneDX provides the ability to describe components and their dependency on other components. The dependency graph is capable of representing both direct and transitive relationships. Components that depend on services can also be represented in the dependency graph. And services that depend on other services can also be represented as well. The next section of the SBOM is compositions. With CycloneDX, you have a way to describe the completeness of every service, every component assembly, and even every dependency relationship. Oftentimes, it may not be known if a piece of software includes another component or not. CycloneDX allows SBOM authors to describe the parts of the SBOM that are complete or incomplete in general, or maybe it's incomplete because it only lists the first-party components, or incomplete because it only lists the third-party components, or maybe completeness is just otherwise unknown. CycloneDX is highly extensible and provides two ways organizations can add capabilities to the spec while remaining compliant to the standard. The simplest approach is to leverage properties. Properties are a name value store which are applicable to any component, service, or to the SBOM itself. Properties allow organizations to add additional metadata about components or services which are not defined in the spec itself. Oftentimes, properties will consist of information only applicable or relevant to the organization using them, but they're a great way to extend the capabilities of CycloneDX in a fully supportable way. The second way that CycloneDX is extensible is through the use of additional namespaces in XML. When using XML as a serialization format, CycloneDX provides a number of extension points where organizations or industries can create their own schemas and overlay them onto the base CycloneDX spec. This is a bit heavier approach, but can be extremely useful when complex data needs to be represented. JSON schema isn't extensible in the same way that XML is, which makes it a bit more difficult and not overly elegant. So CycloneDX provides two JSON schemas, one of which is strict and prohibits the use of anything not defined in the CycloneDX spec. The other is more relaxed, which does allow for this behavior. For most organizations, use of CycloneDX properties is highly recommended, as they provide a consistent way to represent data not defined in the spec, and it works across all serialization formats. So that's the anatomy of a CycloneDX SBOM. Pretty simple, isn't it? Links to use cases and examples are in the description below. If you found this video useful, please be sure to like and subscribe so you'll get notified of new episodes that can help you and your organization get the most from CycloneDX.